What's going on, guys? News Adventure Time here, guys, to do the episode for review for the half-hour premiere of Adventure Time for Season 6, Part 2, called Escape from the Citadel. So, of course, Escape from the Citadel continues on exactly where Wake Up ended. So, as we see in Escape from the Citadel, Finn and Jake are entering now the Citadel Crystal Dimension, where his dad is being held. So, once they get there, the crystal people take the Lich, since he committed the cosmic crime. They froze him up, and now they put him in one of the jail cell blocks, as you want to call it. But the Lich knew that was going to happen. I don't know how, but he just knew. So now he had a plan with, like, the way he killed Prismo in Wake Up was, like, with his breath. Like, he got something out, and, like, black stuff was coming out, and it killed him. I'm guessing he used the same technique that got to free himself, but he was doing it slowly, since that polycrystal thing is probably really, really strong somehow. So, Finn and Jake thought that the Lich was actually prisoner now. They thought that his plan failed, and he was trapped there forever. Well, they were wrong. But first, since Finn and Jake thought that he was trapped, they're not looking for his father, and immediately, Jake says, "Hey, look at that guy, he looks just like you," and then Finn jumps down and says, "Daddy!" But then, unfortunately, Finn isn't smart. As I said in my previous videos, he's a boy who never went to school or anything, never had book smarts or anything smart like us. So he thought his father worked at the Citadel. You know, I mean, Finn is a really strong hero, so they thought they got his stuff from his father's side. So they finally see Finn's dad. He's frozen up, he looks just like him, and then they actually find out that Finn's dad is actually a bad guy. Well, we don't know that 100%, but, you know, there's just a lot of things that you guys are probably here for, and you guys are probably here because, you know, Finn's dad was a mean jerk. He was a prisoner from right there. You know, of course, he wasn't a real dad. He was one of those stupid guys who, like, probably, I'm getting to example in real life. He's probably one of those people who would probably, you know, probably get drunk and, like, probably, you know, don't care about their children, get into trouble, go to jail. Like, maybe that kind of person, if he was in real life, like, in our dimension. But, like, you know, this is Adventure Time, but, like, he's kind of a bad, not like a bad person, but just not like a nice person, as you would say. So, here's the biggest thing that I found in this episode. I'm going to be showing you two pictures. One right now, as you can see, this is Finn's dad, as we see right now. As you can see right now, he has a beard, he has like only one hair sticking out of his head, you know, he's wearing a suit, he's wearing like, he looks not buff, but like, his chest is a little bigger than like his legs and everything. And now, here is the picture of Finn's dad in the farm world, as we saw in the episode, the Lich, Jake the dog, and Finn the human. Guys, compare them, they look almost exactly the same. I mean, not 100% the same, because, you know, that was Farm World Finn. That was if the Lich never existed, the bomb never got off. I mean, timeline changes things. It could change how people look, but not that much. So compare these two guys. Go back right and forth them. They both have the curly hair. They both have the beard. They both look kind of the same. Not 100% the same, except for the nose and the eyes and, like, maybe the ears. The reason this being is because, remember, when a mushroom bomb happens, it destroys the eyes, the nose, the ears, a little bit of the mouth, and stuff like that. That's actually true. If you guys never do that, it causes birth defects. You know, the cause of that, that's why none of the heroes from Adventure Time, nobody has noses, due to the fact of the mushroom bomb. Since the mushroom war was 1,000 years old, nobody but, like, Simon and Lemongrab have a nose, because, like, you know, Princess Bubblegum created Lemongrab, and Simon, aka Ice King, is more than 1,000 years old, and he was born before the Great Mushroom War, so that's the reason why he has a nose. So continuing on, these two characters look the same. And continuing on from the episode review now, so Finn and Jake find Finn's lost dad, they free him, but of course the Lich is still there. He finally escapes free, and now wants to kill Finn's dad and all that, but, you know, Finn tries his best to ask his dad the number one question why he did this. And that question is, "Dad, why did you leave me alone in the forest when I was little?" You know, and we would say something, in real life, we would say something like, "Son, I'm really sorry I did that. It was a hard time." But no, his dad is stupid. I mean, we, like, at least 80% of us probably hate Finn's dad because he's a jerk. That's basically the best word to describe him, a jerk. I mean, he never loved Finn. He probably never loved his mom too, but I mean the reaction I got when Finn told him that, and the reaction I got when his dad told him an answer, "Oh, well, you know me, I'm a funny person." Then Finn right there sad, then Jake just holding on, like touching him, saying, "It's okay, pal," like looking at his dad with a mad face, and then he says, "Oh, well, how did I know that you left me?" He's a baby. What the heck? How can I leave you if he's a baby? I mean, it's like he has an excuse for everything. I just think he's a bad parent, still an evil person, and didn't even care that his son's arm got cut off. I mean, so continuing on, Finn's dad. So Finn and Jake free Finn's dad. The prisoners came out because the Citadel is a place where prisoners, and I mean like, I'm not talking like people like the Lich, worser people than that, get held right there. So they escape too, and like want to escape. So they actually destroyed all the Citadel guards. I don't know what you want to call them, Crystal guards. I don't know what you want to call them, but I just call them Citadel guards. So they kill them all, and then the Lich actually escapes and wants to kill Finn and Jake. So they don't have them the gems. For I don't know how the Lich didn't control Finn and Jake's mind, because without the gems he can control their mind, but he didn't. But like he was able to kind of control them in some way, because the whole place got dark black. And then of course, okay, excuse me about that. And then the Lich just says fall. Then they fall down. But Finn, he's a strong boy. He's like super strong. He tries to get up, and like, so when. I forgot, I skipped this part, but I forgot it, so I'm continuing on. So one of the crystal guards zapped Finn's dad's leg, which was kind of weird. I mean, you can see his bone popping out. I mean, in real life, I mean, Adventure Time people try to keep things as real as possible. But if you're probably thinking, why did that happen? I mean, think about it. Nuclear waste is in everybody, even Finn. I mean, he's a human though, but he still has like maybe 5 or 10% of his body is like human waste. That's why he doesn't feel that much pain. Did you guys ever know that? I mean, toxic waste can like change you. It can make you stronger, buffer, and stuff like that. So like probably when like Finn's dad got zapped by the crystal guard, it probably really it did hurt, like he said, but he's a prisoner, he's a strong, like bad guy. So like he and then like Finn got that stuff from the Citadel guards and like put him on it, his leg got healed, and then just left him. I mean, he says, "All right, time to defeat the Lich." And he says, "Where's Dad?" And then he just like, bam. But here's another thing. I mean, there's just so many things to talk about this episode. I mean, he says, "My name is Martin." Wasn't it Mertens? There's something when I'm confused. This is one of those things that makes you feel like, is that really Finn's dad? I mean, I'm not 100% sure. Because in Finn the Human and Jake the Dog, we see that Finn's family's name is called Mertens. That's their last name, Mertens. Mertons. Yeah. But then he said his name is Martins with the A instead of a U. Martons. Martins. So I got kind of confused right there. I don't know if they changed their last name to different because of the mushroom war or something like that, but it was kind of confusing. I'm still having second thoughts of thinking that that's Finn's dad. I mean, it looks like him, but I don't know. It could be just something to suspend Adventure Time, but that's another thing that, I mean, Finn doesn't even know that that's his last name too. Finn actually thinks that his last name is the Human. He actually thinks that his real name is Finn the Human. That's his full name, Finn the Human, first and last name, I presume. So getting on, so Finn and Jake had to defeat the Lich, but then the Lich trapped them, and then Finn, like I said, he was able to kind of break free. The Lich was about to grab Finn, but right before that, Finn grabbed one of that goo stuff and threw it at the Lich. I mean, the Lich is made out of all of skeleton. He's made of all bone and everything. So throwing that at him, I'm guessing he turned back into his original form. I mean, Or maybe he just grew body parts now. I mean, he turned into a baby or something like that because he's really big, but it's like he just turned into a baby. I didn't get that at all. I mean, I would predict that the Lich was still evil, but just like it maybe in a body form, you know what I mean? I mean, this episode was really confusing, really sad, really mad, really amazing, but you know, a lot of stuff into it that we didn't understand still. I know I'm gonna miss something important, so I'm trying to think if I am missing anything important. Probably think of something. So continuing on, so the Finn actually finally defeats the Lich. This is probably the last time we're gonna see the Lich, maybe or maybe not, since he threw all that stuff and made him like human or like back into a person. But then Finn tells Jake to defeat the Lich while he goes after his dad, and the most part that we all of us, especially me, got shocked at. So Finn tries to so one of the monsters breaks the pole in half, which Finn is trying to climb to go to his dad. So he grabs one hand, he grabs his right hand with one of the pole and his left hand at the bottom of the pole, and then the pole is breaking because the prisoners and his dad are trying to escape, but Finn does not want to let go. Do you know how hard that is? Like being getting your arms pulled at? And then Jake tries to step in and help him, but then it's still not enough. And then tells Finn that he has to let go, but he does not want to. I mean, he doesn't want to let go of his dad. He never wants to lose him. Do you ever want to lose faith in your dad? I mean, look, we all know that Finn's dad is kind of a jerk, but you are not his dad. Imagine that is your father. I mean, you mostly accept your father. I mean, not mostly accept your father, but like, at least know that that's your father and still want to protect him and never want to lose him, unless you know he's 100% jerk, never liked you or anything. But like, he wasn't that bad and still wanted to protect him. So then, of course, Finn tries to save his dad, and then the grass sword, like grieving for his master, trying to grow his hand bigger and save Finn and try to grab that other end of the pole or whatever the heck it is, and then just snap. His grass sword tries to grab on in his hand, and his hand snaps in half, and the prisoners leave. So, if you didn't notice this at the end, Finn's dad says something before they leave. He says, "Oh, what about?" And then they just leave. Well, Finn's dad actually said, "Oh, wait, what about air?" And then, poosh, they just escape. What do you guys think happened right there? Because I'll actually show. If I remember, I'll put this clip. Finn's dad said, "Oh shoot, what about air?" And then boosh, they just leave. And then Finn falls down in the water. And another sad thing that I saw was, of course, when one of the little goo things to repair a human body or something like that went to Finn's hand. It did not repair his hand. It just grew like a flower on him, which was really sad. You know why it grew a flower? Because his hand is technically connected to his grass sword. So it's like saying, you cut a grass or you cut a plant, you put that goo in it, it grows a new part of the plant. So since technically like it wasn't 100% his hand, it was the grass sword. So that's why it grew a flower, because you know that was the grass sword. And so you know, Finn and Jake say that it's okay, everything's gonna be fine. And the last part was really sad and like made me like kind of happy. You know, Shelby comes out and like, you can actually see tears coming out of Shelby, or it's tears or water, I don't know which, comes out, and then it goes next to Finn's leg and just like snuggles with him. And then Finn just looking at him, like smiling. And then, you know, right there saying that everything's gonna be fine. But before this ends, we see that Finn and Jake go to Tree Trunks' house with the Lich. Now, if you remember correctly, I know 100%, I saw this episode a bunch of times. They go to a scene where Tree Trunks and Mr. Pig. Tree Trunks says, "Mr. Pig, I think we should get a dog." And then, boosh, a knock on the door. At first, I thought they said they were gonna get a child, like a baby, you know, like a pet or something. But I heard she said a dog. That's what she said, dog. And then, you know, they open the door. They see the Lich as like a little baby in a cat basket, and that's mostly for like adoption babies. And then Tree Trunks says, "This changes everything." So I'm guessing that's either their, nah, I wouldn't say pets. That's their child now. They're gonna have like a child, I'm like, you know what, that's just really amazing. So, I hope I cleared up everything for this episode, guys. At the end of my outro, you should see my previous video or my next video of my other episode review for Wake Up. Thank you guys so much. I hope you guys enjoyed this review for Escape from the Citadel. Make sure you check out Wake Up. And I'll be here to post the preview for James 2 and other stuff for Adventure Time. I'm Moose at Adventure Time, guys. And I'm out. Peace.